Trials and tribulations is a common staple in the Christian walk and a great necessity. The commander-in-chief was tortured and murdered, and a servant is not greater than his Lord, so we too will also be persecuted. This needs to be expected. First things first, is your trial due to your own sin and rebellion? Are you just merely opening the door to the enemy? Just like Samson, when the Philistines took him and plucked out his eyes, it was because he told his secret to Delilah. He gave in to her manipulation and to the lust of Delilah. So Samson's trial was brought on by his own ignorance and rebellion. Or is your trial from the Father of Lights because you are living righteously and he is trying to test you because he wants to give you more, or he just wants to train you? And the name of the game is trust. If you want to shorten that season, that trial, then trust is the name of the game. Everybody likes to proclaim Psalms 91 over themselves, which is a great chapter, but they fail to recognize that if you don't do verses 1 and 2, then the rest of the chapter doesn't apply. He that dwelleth in the secret place, dwelleth, not visit, not come and go as you please, but dwelleth. And that requires discipline. Another word that most Christians don't like to hear is discipline. On a day-to-day basis, are you living and dwelling with the Lord God Almighty? Verse 2, I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him will I trust. Now, are you truly trusting the Lord, or do you like to manipulate? Are you controlling? Are you picking up the phone all the time and trying to manipulate other people? Are you going to pharmaceuticals? Are you taking things into your own hands, or do you trust that the King of Kings, the God of Creator of heavens and earth, is in control and wants the best for you? So you need to decide for yourself, is the trial coming through sin or is it coming from the Lord for a training exercise? Another observation of trials in the Christian walk, there's multiple biblical examples that trials follow great spiritual victories. You have the Israelites who are finally freed from Egypt after the 10 plagues. They finally get to the Red Sea and here comes a great army ready to decimate them. They're, what's going to happen? They failed to trust in the Lord. They get through the Red Sea. On the other side, they're about to die of thirst, and they don't trust again. You have Samson, who killed 1,000 Philistines, and then right after that, he also is about to die of thirst and cries out to the Lord, am I going to have this great victory and then die of thirst? Now, all this stuff is encompassed in Psalm 7. David pleads for the Lord to vindicate him from his enemies. But he says, if this is because I have repaid evil for those who have done peaceably unto me, then I deserve to be trodden down with the evil. He says, if I am righteous, then Lord, vindicate me. You fight for me, but in you will I trust. Finally, 1 Peter 5:8, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. Now, if you study how lions actually attack, the first thing they do is that they separate you from the rest of the herd and they isolate you.
So they team up, approaching their prey from different angles. Zebras learn to keep their distance, but one zebra is about to violate the first rule of the safari. Always stay with the group.
And they isolate you, and then they start bombarding you, making you tired. Get a bite here, get a bite here, and they just continue to bombard you until you're on the ground, until they're ripping out your heart. So, trials and tribulations, we need to be open and honest with our fellow brothers and sisters about what's going on. Because a major strategy of the enemy is to isolate you from the rest of the family, rest of the body, and to say, oh, you're the only one who's ever dealing with this. You're the only person who's ever struggled with this. Oh, if you let anybody else know what's going on in your head or going on in your life, then they'll reject you. You won't be loved by anybody. Nothing is new under the sun. We all go through the same trials and tribulations. The tactic of the enemy is quite common. So please, be honest. Don't act like you got it all figured out. Don't act like your poop don't stink and that you're the top dog Christian. It's just not the case. We're all in this together. We're all on this blue rock hurtling through space together. So our trials and tribulations are common. You are not alone. God is still on the throne. Again, the name of the game is trust. If you want to shorten your season of trials and tribulation, trust in the Lord and lean not on your own understanding. God bless.